So far you have learned about algebraic expressions and some equations also. So example sums of some expressions. Examples of some algebraic expressions like x square plus x plus 3, x plus y, xy plus 3, 4x cube plus 5x square minus 3x minus 9. So these are all examples of algebraic expression. Some simple equations already you know. So some examples of some equations. So you learn that is 2x is equal to 5, x minus 5 is equal to 3, 2x minus 9 is equal to 1, 5y minus 3 is equal to 1. So like this, you learn about this type of equations. So look at the examples here. In the equations, there is an equality sign. So this is known as equality sign. So this equality sign is missing in the algebraic expression. So here, so far you learned this type of equations. These are known as linear equations, where the degree of the variable is 1. But here in this expression, some expressions are of more than one variable. Here x plus y is there. Here two variables are there, one x and one y. Here also xy plus 3, here two variables are there, x and y. But in equations, so far you learn about one variable only. So here in this session also, we will learn the equations which are deals with linear expressions. Those are known as linear equations in one variable. Linear equations in one variable. So this type of equations are deal with linear expressions. So our linear expressions are those in which the degree of the variable is 1. For example, 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. So this is an example of linear equations in one variable. So let us learn some properties of this type of equations. So let us revise some properties of simple equation what you have learned already. So first, an algebraic equation is an equality involving variables. It has an equality sign. The expression on the left of the equality sign is the left hand side or simply LHS. And the other side or the right side of the equality sign is the right hand side or simply RHS. So take an example. The same example I am taking, that is 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. So this is a linear equation in one variable. So here this x is known as the variable. So here the degree of x is 1, so that's why it is known as linear equation. And this is the equality sign. This is known as the equality sign. And the left hand part of the equality sign is known as the left hand side, LHS. So LHS is equal to 2x minus 3 and RHS is equal to 7. So next come to second property. Next property, in an equation, the values of expressions on the left hand side and right hand side are equal. This happens to be true only for certain values of the variable. These values are the solutions of the equations. So let us take our previous example, that is 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. So we know x is equal to 5 is the solution. So here it is said the LHS will be equal to RHS for certain value of the variable. So if we will put the value of x as 5 here, so what will happen to left hand side? LHS is equal to 2 multiplied with 5 minus 3. So this is equal to 10 minus 3, this is equal to 7, which is equal to right hand side. So the value of x is 5, and it is when we put in this equation, then left hand side will be equal to right hand side. So let us take another example. Let us put x is equal to 10. So if we will put x is equal to 10 here, then LHS is equal to 2 multiplied with 10 minus 3 is equal to 20 minus 3 is equal to 17. So this is 17 is not equal to RHS. So from this example we know that the solution of this equation is only x is equal to 5. Next, how to find the solution of an equation? We assume that the two sides of the equation are balanced. We perform the same mathematical operations on both sides of the equation so that the balance is not disturbed. So take that example what we have taken earlier, that is 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. So here our left hand side is 2x minus 3 and right hand side is 7. So according to this property, what operation we will take on the left hand side, we should do it in the right hand side also. So here add 3 in both sides. So that means this implies 2x minus 3 plus 3 is equal to 7 plus 3. So here the balance is not disturbed. So this implies minus 3 plus 3 becomes 0. So 2x is equal to 10. So here 2 is multiplied with x here. So to remove 2 from this expression or this equation, we have to divide 2. So what we have to divide 2 in left hand side, we also have to divide by 2 in the right hand side. So this implies 2x by 2 is equal to 10 by 2. So this implies x is equal to 5. So this is our required solution. So now let us solve some more examples. Next example, solve 2a plus 9 is equal to 4. So next step is our first step. We have to transpose 9 from left hand side to right hand side. So here in the left hand side it is added. So we have to subtract it in the right hand side. So 2y is equal to 4 minus 9. Bracket transposing 9 to RHS. So this implies 2y is equal to minus 5. So this implies here 2 is multiplied with y. So we have to divide 2 in both the sides. So 2y by 2 is equal to minus 5 by 2. So this implies y is equal to minus 5 by 2. So this is our required solution. So now next step is we have to verify whether y is equal to minus 5 by 2 is a solution of this equation or not. So put this value of y in the equation. So what will be our LHS? So 2 multiplied with minus 5 by 2 plus 9. So this becomes minus 5 plus 9. This is equal to 4. So this is our RHS. So here we have verified that LHS is equal to RHS. So our solution is the right solution. Then come to next example. So what is here? X by 3 plus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 3 by 2. So here we have to transpose 5 by 2 to the right hand side. So this implies x by 3 is equal to minus 3 by 2 minus minus 5 by 3. So this implies x by 3 is equal to, this is minus 8 by 2 is equal to minus 4. So then here 3 is divided, so we have to multiply 3 in both the sides. So this implies x by 3 multiplied with 3 is equal to minus 4 multiplied with 3. So this implies x is equal to minus 12. Then we have to verify or we have to check our solution. So what is our LHS? LHS is equal to minus 12 by 3 plus 5 by 2 is equal to, this is minus 4 plus 5 by 2. So this is equal to 2 minus 8 plus 5. So this is minus 3 by 2. So this is our RHS. So our solution is right answer. Next example, solve 15 by 4 minus 7x is equal to 9. So here, first step, we have to transpose 15 by 4 to right hand side. So this implies minus 7x is equal to 9 minus 15 by 4. Transposing 15 by 4 to RHS. So this becomes minus 7x is equal to, this is LCM is 4, 36 minus 15. So this implies minus 7x is equal to 21 by 4. Then minus 7 is multiplied with x. So we have to divide both sides by minus 7. So this implies, this is x is equal to 21 by 4 divided by minus 7 means minus 1 by 7 we have to multiply. So this is dividing minus 7 both sides. So this is minus, we can write is minus 7x by minus 7. So this implies x is equal to, this becomes minus 3 by 4. So this is our required solution. Then we have to verify it. So first put this value of x in the left hand side. So LHS is equal to 15 by 4 minus 7 multiplied with minus 3 by 4. So this becomes 15 by 4, this is plus 21 by 4. So this is equal to 36 by 4. So answer is 9. Our RHS is also 9. So we have verified LHS is equal to RHS. So here the solution x is equal to minus 3 by 4 is the right solution of our given linear equation. So by learning this, all these properties of linear equation in one variable, you can do some more examples or more problems.